Hey everybody, welcome back to my video series on rapid wireframing. My name is Billy Carlson and I'm a design educator here at Balsamiq. All right, so let's just quickly review what we've done so far. So I created two screens along with you. Right here we have our restaurant listing screen and we have our menu. And then I went ahead and created a menu item detail page, something that you can tap on, select your options here, and add it to your order. I have two options. I have one that's full of content and one that's empty. I always think it's really important to design different states of pages. And then I have a cart page listing everything that I've ordered and a checkout page. So what I want to do in this video is start off with adding some images and adding a little more content into my screens here. And then what I'm going to do is demonstrate how you can create alternate versions of each of these designs, which I think is important to keep iterating and exploring. Once I know that I have a design that fits all of my content, I can kind of play around with it a little more and have some fun and explore. All right, let's get started. So the first thing I'm going to do is open up my panel here. And what I did is I went and downloaded lots of different images to use for this so I can show you how I would do it. What I'm going to do is grab a logo and drop it in. Since this is too big, I'm just going to hold on to the Command or Control key and hit the minus button on my keyboard to zoom out. And now I'm going to select the image and select crop. So it gives me the ability to easily crop out the logo since they had two versions. And just hit crop image, and then there you go. The next thing I'm going to do is, okay, this is just about square. And this is 92 by 92. So I'm just going to drag it to this corner and go to my property inspector and type in 92. And if I hit the tab button, it'll go to the next open field and I'll hit 92 again. And then it's right in the place it needs to be. And the final thing is, actually I'll zoom in, is use this sketch it feature so that it doesn't stand out too much and it looks more like a wireframe. All right, I went in and added imagery to each of the screens just to make it look a little more finished, a little more polished, something that will be easy to show your friend or your client and get their feedback on the design. And it has a little more context to it, right? A box with an X through it. It doesn't have as much context as a restaurant menu item here, or a logo here. And this will make it easier for me to work on iterations. Now what I'm going to do is actually put each of these wireframes on their own wireframe screen in Balsamiq so that I can make iterations to each screen and not change anything. So it's very simple to do. The first thing you do is you can click and drag and hit the Command C button. You can also go up to here and hit copy. And then the next thing you do is hit the plus button here and then go to edit, hit paste. And now you have this design on its own screen, on its own wireframe, and then you can change the name. Okay, now we'll go back up and we'll do this one more time. I'm gonna this time use Command C and hit the plus button and then hit Command V. That would be Control V on a PC. So now I'm gonna go back and do this for every screen. As you can see, now I have all of these screens put on their own wireframe page in Balsamiq. And I can now show you this great feature that allows me to easily make new versions or alternate versions. So how I did that is I hover in here, there's a down arrow, I click on it and click create alternate version. There is no difference, but now I have two versions of the same screen. And you can see this little icon here. I can click on it and go to the official version or go to the alternate version. Now that I have this alternate set up, what I'm going to do is make a few changes. The first one I'm thinking is there's a lot of text on the screen, so I might get rid of and make it more image heavy, having the name of the restaurant and the logo be the primary. The second thing I want to do is add a search feature. I like the idea of, you know, being able to tap in and search for something I want instead of having to pick from your predefined categories. So put that up really quick. What I'm doing now is I'm going to hit colon, type in magnifying glass, and just pick one that I like. I'll pick the thicker one. It's called solid. Add some space here and call it search. Okay. So now I can just change the text to something a little lighter so it doesn't stand out. Also, I don't want my branding for the food hall to take up too much space. I want search and I want the restaurant logos. That to me is the most important. When I go bigger the size, the more prominent it would be. So I consider lowering the opacity of the text so that it doesn't jump out at you as much. Okay. And the next thing I'm gonna do is focus on these images. The nice thing is it's all set up in a grid so I can deselect all of them and move them very quickly. And the final thing I wanna do is make these taller. I'm gonna make these two boxes have a darker background to match their logo. Okay, so I went through and made some other edits, including changing the style of the cart icon so that's less prominent. That really makes the search area jump out. I updated the search text so that it says menu items or restaurant. I think this text within a search box helps the user understand exactly what they can do with it. Made the logo a little smaller, focused on the words, and then made these a lot bigger. Now, I have two designs that I can choose from. I have this design, my first one. There's a background image, there's categories, and then we have this card design with all of these restaurants, and then a new design that makes the search a lot more prominent, and then showing less restaurants, but it still will be like a scrolling experience. I think it looks good. Okay, I'm gonna do a similar design now for this. So I'm gonna follow the same protocol. Create alternate. Now I have a totally new design and I'm going to apply some of these other changes to that. So some of the other things I want to do is maybe on this screen, I would have a big banner image, but maybe get rid of this and have search. What I can do is take a few things from the previous design, which would be the search and this big banner here. Because I still want to use this, but I think I want to change the top. What I can do then is take this, move it to the top. So that's sort of like a header. And so one of the things I was thinking is I want to add, and a lot of this feedback would just be, a lot of these designs are thinking of different ways that maybe a restaurant owner would want to display their. So here I just say search for restaurant, search for menu items because I'm in the menu. What I'm thinking is I want to have text here plus the number. I could design it a little differently. So I will probably make this call like popular picks so that people know what other people are ordering or most popular items. I'm going to add a rule line. And how I do that is I hit a slash key, which brings up this quick add menu here. And just type in the letter H and I'll go down the H rule and hit enter. So I use the keyboard down arrow and selected H rule. And then hit enter and it just puts it on my screen for me nice and easy and slide that across. What I'm trying to do here is I'm thinking I want like a listing of the top food items, maybe do 6 or 4. And then I will do probably just add this below it, something like that. But it's a way for me to add a few more items and try out another design essentially too, right? So one of the things I like to do is size things once and see if they fit across. And then I'll show you. Because I'm going to make these two columns. I want two columns, obviously, to fit nice and easy. I've made them 200 pixels. I need a good space. So 200 is too big. So I can now just copy these two and fit it to the width that I want. What I want to do, actually, is maybe put the price up here. So I'll have text boxes be 150. And I'm going to put the price there. I can do a different design. I think this kind of stands out too much. So I'll take this. Price is important. I can make it the same text size and weight of the main title. So, and now we sort of have an established look for this. And I can just copy it. So what I did is I click and drag. It highlights everything. Hold down the Option key and drag it down to a good spot. So I added a few more elements. I like where this is at though. This is a different option easier for me just to read here and not have the images in the way, but I can continue to have it further down the list. This can just be the popular picks. What I could do is just probably take this right here, change the style. So this is 16 with a line. So I'll just copy the line and make this 16. I can just show that this goes off the screen. Highlight everything, go to edit group or command G, and then you have the ability to crop after that. And that's really nice just to sort of show it comes off the page. Okay, so this is another version of the same page. And now you can see this is the alternate and this is the official. You can kind of see like, which one do I like better? You can go and show people and see what resonates.
Thank you. And we'll see you in the next video, which discusses linking wireframes together to show how a user can move through the application.